Shunyavadi Paschacyate Satarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. All right, so we're going to hear today, we're studying Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, and we're going on today to chapter number 17, is it? The descent,
yes.
Of the descent of the river Ganges, yes. So, Sukadeva Goswami is instructing Maharaj Parikshit, and he's going to tell us about how the Ganges appears.
Sukadeva Goswami gave Maharaj Parikshit 讲述 这个恒河是怎么降落.
So it begins with the appearance of Lord Vamanadev, and Lord Vamanadev comes to beg charity from Bali Maharaj.
这是从主巴拉马哈拉吉面前显现，他想向巴拉马哈拉吉祈祷。So,
of course, Lord Vamanadev wanted 3 steps of land from Bali Maharaj, and Bali Maharaj agreed. All right, if that's all you want, you take 3 steps of land.
Vamanadev 向巴拉马哈拉吉祈求三步之地的这个布施。 Bali Maharaj 很高兴地就答应了这一切。好，我给你这个三步的布施土地。So
when Lord Vamanadev took the step, he assumed a gigantic form, and with his left foot, he covered right to the end of the universe.
主 Vamanadev 当他要了这个三步之地之后，他马上就。
And he made his big toe of his left foot, it made a hole in the covering of the universe.
他的左脚的脚趾刺破了宇宙的覆盖.
So the water of the causal ocean is outside the universe. And that water, some drops of water from the causal ocean entered, and that became the Ganges River.
有几滴水呢，就从元阴之阳顺着这个洞给漏了下来，这个水从元阴之阳漏下来就成了恒河。So
this water, which we call the Ganges River, actually comes originally from the causal ocean.
神圣的恒河，它其实真正的源头是元阴之阳。And
this water has also washed the lotus feet, the lotus foot of Lord Vamanadev.
这个恒河还沐浴了主Vamanadev的莲花足。So
it is said Lord Vamanadev's foot was covered with red powder. Even today, you see ladies sometimes, they have the red powder on their feet. So the water of the Ganges has a reddish pink color. So just by bathing in this water, we can purify our mind. The water of the Ganges will purify our mind.
So
And the water of the Ganges is always pure.
恒河总是纯洁的。
Because it touched the feet of the Lord, because it's coming through, after touching the feet of the Lord, then it descends into the universe.
它先是触碰了主莲花足，然后再降临到这个物质宇宙，降临到这个宇宙。
So one of the names of the river Ganges is Vishnupadi.
恒河的其中一个名字叫 Vishnupadi.
Then it got other names like Bhagirathi and Janavi.
它还有其他的名字叫 Bhagirathi, Janavi.
Bhagirathi, Maharaj Bhagirath was the one who did the austerities to bring Ganges down to the earth planet, from the heavenly planets down to the earth planet.
Maharaj Bhagirathi, 他做了苦行，把恒河从天堂星宿带到地球上。
No, the king's name is Maharaj Bhagirath, but the river is like his daughter, so it's called Bhagirathi, but his name was Bhagirath.
哦，这个国王叫 Bhagirathi,
这个国王叫 Bhagirath、
哦、
Bhagirath not Bhagirathi, Bhagirathi is the daughter of Bhagirath.
这个国王叫 Bhagirath, 然后他经过苦行把恒河从天堂带下来之后，所以这个恒河他的另一个名字好像就是他女是他女儿的这个名字命名叫 Bhagirathi.
And then when the Ganges was flowing, at one point it flowed right through the ashram of Janumuni. So Janumuni was upset because the water came right through his ashram, so he drank all the Ganga.
这个恒河到了Janumuni的这个 ashram, 甚至把它淹没了，所以 Janumuni 他非常的生气，他把整个恒河给喝了。
So then Maharaj Bhagirath came and he begged Janumuni, please give back the Ganges, please, we need the water of the Ganges to liberate all the souls.
So Maharaj Bhagirath, he 就向那个 Janumuni 向他祈祷，请把恒河还回来，我们需要这个恒河来解救所有的这些人们。
So then Maharaj Bhagirath brought the water out from his knee.
所以Maharaj Bhagirath brought water from the knee.
Janumuni brought the water out from his knee.
Janumuni 把恒河从他的 from knee.
是他的膝盖。
从他的膝盖中拿出来。
Yeah. So it got the name Janavi.
所以这个恒河也有另外一个名字叫加纳维。
So the water came into the universe, and after a long time, 1,000 millennium, the water came to Dhruvaloka, the top, the highest planet in the universe.
经过一千个年代之后，这个恒河降落到这个宇宙最高的这个星球，叫 Dhruvaloka。
So Dhruvaloka is also Vishnupada. The lotus is at the lotus feet of Vishnu.
Dhruvaloka 也是 Vishnupada, 是处在主 Vishnu 莲花足上。
So in this way, Sukadeva Goswami is telling us the glory of the Ganges water.
这样 ，Sukadeva Goswami 在向我们描述恒河的荣耀。
Simply by contacting this water, sinful people can become purified.
仅仅是和这个恒河接触，罪恶的人能够得到拯救。
They get benefit materially and spiritually.
他们不仅从物质上，也从灵性上得到益处。
You bathe in the water, it will help you get rid of all kinds of diseases.
你们在恒河中沐浴，你可以免疫于各种各样的疾病。
And it will also help you to develop devotion for the Supreme Lord.
同样也可以发展出你对至尊人格守神奉爱的态度。
So many great yogis and sages, they would live on the bank of the river Ganges and bathe there every day.
所以很多的伟大的圣人每一天都会在恒河旁边住着，在恒河那里定期的沐浴。
Shankaracharya also wrote beautiful poems about the Ganga.
Shankaracharya 也描述了很多关于恒河的赞美的祷文。
And even the Buddhists also, they have great respect for the river Ganga.
即便是佛教徒对 Ganga 也有很好的尊敬。
And just by living near there, people become advanced in spiritual consciousness.
仅仅是住在这个河流的附近，人们在灵性上都会自然的进步。
Okay, so then, Sukadeva Goswami explains. So Dhruva Maharaj, Sukadeva Goswami explains about Dhruva Maharaj, that Dhruva Maharaj was a very great devotee and he was known for his very, very strong determination to do devotional service.
Sukadeva Goswami 开始描述 Dhruva Maharaj. Dhruva Maharaj 是一位伟大的奉献者，他以坚定的决心做奉爱服务而闻名。
So Dhruva Maharaj knew about the water of the Ganges coming from the feet of Vishnu.
Dhruva Maharaj 知道这个河水将会是从主威士努足下流淌出来的。
So even though Dhruva Maharaj is in the topmost planet in the universe, Dhruva Loka, to this very day he keeps the water of the Ganga on his head.
即便是今天在这个物质宇宙最上的在这个宇宙最上的朱瓦洛卡，朱瓦玛拉仍是把这个恒河之水放在自己的头上。
Because Dhruva Maharaj is always thinking of Krishna, so he is always in ecstasy.
因为 Dhruva Maharaj 总是想着 Krishna, 所以他总是处于狂喜之中。
And his body is always, tears are coming always from his eyes, and his body is always shaking in ecstasy.
他的眼睛总是流淌出的泪水，他的身体在不断的颤抖。
So this is a symptom of a great devotee, a Mahabhagavat. So Dhruva Maharaj is showing us the behavior of the Mahabhagavat.
这是一位纯粹奉献者 Mahabhagavat 他的特征。Dhruva Maharaj 也向我们展示这个特征。
And we know also how Lord Chaitanya spent first 24 years of his pastimes in the bank of the Ganga, bathing in the Ganges every day.
我们知道主 Chaitanya 用他24年的时间在恒河岸边，每一天也在恒河中沐浴。
So then Sukadeva Goswami talks about the seven great sages who are all sons of Brahma. So they live on the planet just below Dhruva Loka. They each have their own planets just below Dhruva Loka.
然后 Sukadeva Goswami 就给我们描述七大圣贤，他们每个人有各自的星球，他们的星球所在就在 Dhruva Loka 下面的一些地方。
And they also keep the water of the Ganges on their head, on their hair.
他们也在头发中间还流淌着恒河水，他们每一天也。
And they consider this water of the Ganges, this is the ultimate wealth.
这七大圣贤他们得出结论，他们认为恒河是终极的财富。
And it's the perfection of all austerities.
他们是所有苦行的完美。
And the best means of getting transcendental life.
他们认为这是执行超然生活的方法。
So they don't bother about any other religious processes. They just simply take advantage of the water of the Ganges.
他们不被其他的方法所打扰，他们只是从恒河之水中受益。
So, Prabhupada explains that there's both devotees and they have also the impersonalists, but they both have respect for the river Ganges.
Prabhupada 讲，有奉献者，也有非人格主义者，但是呢，他们都非常尊敬恒河。
So they all, even though personalists are impersonalists, devotees are not devotees, gyanis, they all keep the water of the Ganges on their head.
无论是奉献者，还是非人格主义者，还是那些非奉献者，他们总是头上戴着恒河水。
Even if one is a pure devotee, but if one is even perfect in Krishna consciousness, still he will take advantage of the water of the Ganges to keep it on his head.
即便是一位纯粹的奉献者，一位在 Krishna 知觉中的纯粹奉献者，他也会把恒河水放在他的头上。
There's nothing else more important.
他认为别的其他的事情都不重要。
Okay, let's see. So that we have on the top of the universe, you have Dhruvaloka, then you have the seven planets of the great sages.
我们讲述了这个宇宙中最高的星球 Dhruvaloka, 还有下面的七大圣贤。
So the Ganges water flows like that. It comes in from the causal ocean, and then goes first to Dhruvaloka, and then it goes down to the planets of the seven sages, seven great sages.
恒河之水的流经也是就这样，它从元婴之阳中，元婴之阳漏下，然后呢，先经过Dhruvaloka，然后再到七个星球。
Then it's carried in the aeroplanes of the demigods, and it's carried to the moon planet.
然后，这些恒河水被天堂的这些飞机运到月球上。
Yeah, there's many, many billions of aeroplanes of the demigods, and they carry this Ganges water.
有成千上万个天堂的飞机，这些半神人他们在运送恒河之水。
So they carry the water down to Chandraloka, the planet of the moon.
他们在运送恒河之水，送到月球之上。
And then from there, then it goes to Brahma's place, which is on top of Mount Meru.
从月球，然后再到主 Brahma 所居住的梅如山的居所。
Remember, we heard when we were reading about Jambudvip, we heard about Mount Meru, and Lord Brahma, he's got his residence on the top of Mount Meru.
我们在上一次讲了 Jambudvip 的描述。那里有梅如山，主 Brahma 就住在梅如的山顶。
So this way the Ganges water is coming down. You can understand how it's coming from up the highest, from the spiritual world, from the causal ocean. And then it's coming to the lotus feet of Lord Vamanadev, then to Dhruvaloka, then to the planets of the sages.
如此我们可以想象恒河它是怎么来的。他先是从元婴之阳，然后再到 Vamanadeva 的莲花族，然后再到Dhruvaloka，然后再到七个圣贤的这些星球，然后再到 Chandraloka。
And from Chandraloka, then it comes to the place of Brahma on top of Mount Meru, and then from Mount Meru, then it comes to the Himalayas, and then it comes down through India.
从 Chandraloka, 然后再到主 Brahma 的梅如山的居所， 从梅庐山然后再到喜马拉雅山，从喜马拉雅山再到我们现在流经的这些地球上的这些地方。
Just like if you go to Haridwar, you can see there the Ganga coming from, it's come from the Himalayas.
就像我们去 Haridwar 那个地方，我们看到喜马拉雅山那里有恒河流经。
So we are hearing, you know, it sounds unbelievable that the water of the Ganges could be carried in airplanes, but this is the information which we are given in the scriptures.
有时候我们会觉得天堂的飞机满载着恒河的水，这是一种很不可思议的，但是呢，我们就是从经典中接触这种描述。
We see people today, they have so much trouble to go to one planet, one higher planet above the earth, that they cannot go. They went one time and then so many other people died, there were so many disasters.
我们看到当今地球上有各种各样的问题，很多人想去其他的星球，但是他们去不了，他们无能为力。
But when we hear about the demigods and how they're carrying the water of the Ganges in their airplanes, we think, oh no, it cannot be. But they're much more powerful than we are.
然而我们当听到这些半圣人用天堂的飞机载着恒河水的时候，我们就觉得这些事情是不可相信的。但是呢，我们应该理解，他们确实比我们更有力量。
So when it comes on the top of Mount Meru, on the top of Mount Meru there, then it divides into four branches.
当这个恒河之水到达梅鲁山的山顶的时候，它被分为了四条支流。
So it's known by different names.
然后这四条支流有各自不同的名字。
One name is the Sita. One name is Alakananda, another is Chaksu, and other one is Bhadra.
这些名字分别是 Sita, Alakananda, Chaksu, Bhadra.
Right, and then from there, then it goes into the ocean.
这些恒河支流，它们汇向了大海，最后。
Right, we know the Alakananda, we've heard of the Alakananda.
我们听过阿拉卡兰达。
So, Sukadeva Goswami tells us about these different branches, where they flow.
Sukadeva Goswami 给我们讲述了这四条支流，它们是怎么样流经的。
So, the branch known as Sita goes through Brahmapuri.
Sita 这条支流，它流经的是 Brahmapuri.
And then it goes to a nearby mountain, because it's on Mount Meru, then it goes to another mountain nearby called Kesarachala Mountain.
它从梅鲁山然后流到另一条这个山叫 Kesarachala 山。
And then from Kesarachala Mountain, the Ganges goes to the Ganga Madana Mountain.
从 Kesarachala 山到 Ganga Madana 山。
Right, when Hanuman came to get the herb to cure Lakshman after Lakshman had been injured by the son of Ravan, Lakshman was unconscious and Hanuman had to come to get the herb to cure him. He came to the Ganga Madana mountain to find the herbs.
这里提到的这个甘达玛达那山，就是哈努曼曾经举起的那个山，不是曾经举，就是哈努曼曾经要在这个山找草药的那个山。哈努曼找草药是为了给这个拉克什曼治病。拉克什曼当时被这个恶魔之子用箭给射击了，然后失去了知觉。哈努曼要从这个山上找草药。
So the, and then from Ganga Madana mountain, then it comes to Bharat Varsh, and then it flows into the ocean.
从 Ganga Madana 然后流到 Bharat Varsh 这片土地，然后再进入到海洋之中。
Then there's another branch, the Chakshu, that falls to the Malyavana mountain.
Chakshu 文明的这条支流，它流经到 Malyavasa 山峰。
And then from there it goes to Ketumala Vasa.
从那里，然后到 Ketumala Vasa 这个地方。
And then it goes to the ocean of.The saltwater ocean.
然后以这种方式在西面到达咸水之洋。
Then the Bhadra, the branch known as Bhadra, that comes from the Mount Meru. It goes to the Kumuda Mountain.
Bhadra 的这条名为 Bhadra 恒河的这条支流，从梅鲁山，然后到 Kumuda 山。
Then to Nila Mountain.
然后到 Nila 山
and then Sweta Mountain,
Sweta 山
and then Shringavan Mountain,
Shringavan 山
and then it comes to into the land known as Kuru.
然后再流到这个 Kuru 之地
and then it goes to the ocean.
然后再到海洋之中
and then the last branch, the Alakananda.That's from, flows from Brahmapuri, from the place of Brahma. Then it passes over the tops of mountains.
这个叫阿拉卡兰达的这条支流从 Brahmapuri, 然后翻过各种山。
Yeah, the mountain like Hemakuta Mountain.
这些山的名字有叫 Hemakuta 山。
And Hemakuta Mountain.
还有黑马库塔山
Then it comes to Bharat Varsh.
然后再到 Bharat Varsha 这片土地
And then flows into the ocean.
最后再流到海洋之中
So anybody who comes to bathe in the water of these rivers, very, very fortunate.
任何在这些河流之中沐浴的人都是非常幸运的
Just simply by bathing in this water,They can people get the results of performing a great sacrifice like the Rajashuya sacrifice or Ashwamedha Yajna.
仅仅是在这些河流中沐浴，一个人就可以取得像伟大的祭祀中得到的成果，比如说 Rajashuya 祭祀、Ashwamedha 祭祀这样伟大的祭祀。
So there's where the Ganges flows into the ocean, that is called Ganga Sagar.
恒河在流到海洋之中的那个地方叫 Ganga Sarga.
Kapila Muni has his ashram there.
Kapila Muni 有一个修院在那个地方。
He is residing there since many millions of years.
百万年以前 Kapila Muni 就居住在那里。
And he's still living there today.
他今天仍然居住在那里。
There's a big festival there every year in the month of January or February.
在每一年的一二月期间，那里有一个巨大的节日。
It's called that day is called Makar Sankranti.
这个节日叫 Makara Sankranti.
Yeah, that's the day when the sun changes its direction from moving south. It starts to move north.
那个时候，太月亮改变它的这个方位，从南边到北边。
So it said, if you bathe in the Ganga at that place on that day, then you get liberation.
据说你在那一天、那个时候、那个地方去沐浴的话，你可以得到解脱。
So even though it's very cold at that time of the year, still people want to get liberation. And they go there, they will take their bath in the early morning.
即便那个时候非常的冷，在一二月份的时候，但是人们还是在早上的时候在那个地方沐浴。
So it's a special benefit, special opportunity for people to get free from material life.
那是一种很特别的益处，对于人们来说，想要获得解脱的人。
So there are many other rivers also which flow from Mount Meru.
当然还有其他的很多的河流从梅鲁山流出来。
And these rivers are all like daughters of the mountain.
这些河流就像山的女儿一样。
And they flow to the branches, and they make many different tracts of land.
他们有然后产生很多的支流，然后流经很多的产生很多的土地。
So we had Bhumandala, or in Bhumandala there are 9 varshas, or varsha means the tract of land.
我们听到的 Bhumandala, 然后有很多的 varsha 是土地的意思。
And one of the places is called Bharatvarsha, where we are living.
其中一个 Varsha 叫做 Bharatvarsha， 这就是我们现在所在的这个地方。
And this place is where we're earning our karma。
这个地方被认为是果报的之地。
Right? If we do good karma, we'll be elevated to higher places。
如果我们做一些好的活动，我们会提升到高等的星球上去。
And if we have do very bad activities, we'll go into the lower planets or lower species of life.
如果我们做一些很不好的活动，我们会堕落到一些低等的物种之中。
So it all depends on the activities we do here in Bharatvarsha.
在 Bharatvarsha， 一切都取决于我们所做的活动。
And the other 8 varshas, they're all for.The advanced pious people.
其他的八个 Varsha 之地，他们是为虔诚、高度虔诚的这些人准备的。
It is said people who have been to heaven, they've been to heaven, and they've used up some of their pious activities, and they still have a little bit pious activity left. So they come to these 8 places, these 8 earthly Varshas, 8 places.Which are in the Bhumandala.
据说这些从天堂星球返回的这些人，他们在天堂星球返回之后，他们还有一些虔诚活动，他们就会在这八个 Varsha 之地享受剩余的虔诚活动的这些结果。
We have to understand there are 3 different places in which we can enjoy heavenly life.
我们得了解有三种的天堂享乐之地。
Right, in the heaven, there's the heavenly planets where the demigods live, like that, the planets of the demigods, and heavenly life is there.
有天上的这些天堂星球，半生人们在那里享受。
But there's other places also where you can get heavenly enjoyment.
还有其他一些地方，你也可以享受天堂的这些快乐。
There's a place on earth where you can get also heavenly enjoyment.
在地球上也有天堂之地，你也可以在那里享受天堂的这种快乐。
And there's even places in the lower region of the universe where you can get heavenly enjoyment.
在低等的地狱星球也可以找到天堂之地，可以享受。
So the heavenly places on earth are the 8 varshas, not Bharatvarsha, but the other 8 varshas.
地球上的天堂之地是那八个 varsha， 不是我们所说的 Bharatvarsha， 是 Bharata 之外的这八个 varsha.
So a person may be living in the heavenly planets, and then they come to, when they used up some of their karma, they still have a little left,They come to these 8 regions.
我们刚刚讲到，有一些人他在天堂的这个星球上享受完他的虔诚活动之后，他们会回到这八个 Varsha 之地，享受剩余的虔诚活动的成果。
So, people who are intelligent, they won't waste their time in trying to enjoy like this.
有智慧的人不会 会像这样去享受他的生命。
They'll simply do devotional service so that he can get out of this material world.
他们仅仅只会做奉爱服务，然后离开这个物质世界。
But if you stay in the material world, you'll go up and down, up and down, sometimes the higher planets, sometimes the lower planets.
如果你还是处于物质世界，你只是上上下下，有的时候你在高等的星球，有的时候你在低等的星球。
So a devotee shouldn't be in any ignorance about how to enjoy or where to enjoy.
奉献者因此不要变得这么愚昧，在哪里去享受，如何去享受，去这样的一些想法。
He should take shelter of Krishna through the bona fide spiritual master.
他应该借助一位正宗的灵性导师，托庇于 Krishna。
The bona fide spiritual master will show us how to get out of this material world so that we don't come back, so that we don't get caught in this cycle of trying to enjoy the material world.
一位真正的灵性导师会告诉我们如何离开这个物质世界，他告诉我们如何摆脱这种因果的这种上上下下的这种循环之中。
So it's described, we hear about the life in these eight places, so eight lands, eight tracts of land, that they live 10,000 years, according to our time, they live for 10,000 years, and they're almost like demigods.
在这个八个这个瓦舍之地的人，他们的寿命有一万年，他们就像天堂半世人一样的这种寿命。
And they have the strength of 10,000 elephants.
他们的力量有一万头大象的那样的力量。
And their bodies are very strong.
他们的身体非常强健有力。
And both the men and women, they can enjoy sex for a long time.
那里的男人和女人可以很长时间的享受性生活。
And The women conceive, when there's only 1 year of their life left, at that time, the woman conceives a child.
当女人的寿命只剩下一年的时候，妻子会怀上一个孩子。
So the standard of, you can see that this kind of pleasure which these people have, it's like the pleasure which people had during Treta Yuga.
这些天堂居民的快乐的标准，就像生活在 Treta Yuga 时期的人类的快乐的标准是一样的。
During Treta Yuga, people could have sense gratification without any anxiety.
在 Treta Yuga 银器年代，人们可以享受这个快乐，没有焦虑。
Material miseries only began in the Dwapara Yuga.
物质的痛苦。
And the material miseries became much worse in the Kali Yuga.
而物质的痛苦更甚的，就是更严重的，是从卡利年代开始。
So Prabhupada explains how people in the spiritual world, they don't have any interest in sex at all. Sex is only for the material world.
圣帕帕的也讲到的，在灵性世界没有性生活，性生活只存在于这个物质世界。
So it's described in these eight places of land, there are many beautiful gardens with flowers and fruits.
还描述了在这些土地上有很多的这些花园和果实。
And there's many different kinds of birds.And the beautiful lotus flowers.
有非常美丽的莲花，有各种各样的鸟。
So that whole atmosphere is very pleasing. It's all very sensual.
那里的环境和氛围非常的让人兴奋，而且非常的愉悦。
And the demigods come to enjoy here.
半神人们到这儿享受，到那里享受。
And the wives of the demigods They'll be looking at their husbands with lusty desires.
伴神们的妻子总是带着色欲的眼神看着他们的丈夫。
So in this way, all the people in this heavenly region, in the middle of the universe, in the earthly region, they're very busy in sensual activities, attracting the opposite sex.
八个天堂的瓦萨这些的居民总是很忙着享受这种性生活，被异性的活动所吸引。
So, when you have a lot of opulence, comfort, and then if your mind is not very pure, then certainly you'll become agitated towards sexual desires.
当这个氛围非常的愉悦的时候，或者说你有很多的富裕和财富的时候，如果你不是那么的不依附的话，你很容易就会陷入到这种性生活的享乐。
So although these people are enjoying, they're actually all devotees. They are devotees, but they're just not pure devotees.
虽然这些人们也在享受，但是呢，他们还是奉献者，只不过他们不是纯粹的奉献者。
And we see how people here on this planet, we also, you know, people here on this planet, we also think about enjoying heavenly life.
我们再回到我们现在所居住的这些居住的这个土地上的人们，我们也在想着如何享受生命。
But when we get heavenly pleasure, when we get a lot of opulence, then we forget all about devotional service.
当我们得到很多的富裕和财富的时候，我们也会忘了奉献服务。
But these people in this heavenly region,They never forget. They always remember their servants of the Supreme Lord.
但是在这些瓦萨之地的这些人们，他们虽然也在享受，但是他们永远都不会忘记他们是 Krishna 至尊人格守神的仆人。
Even though they're enjoying sense gratification, they remember their spiritual position.
即便他们在感官享受，他们仍然记得他们灵性的地位。
So, the Supreme Lord wants to show mercy to his devotees.
至尊人格守神想对他的奉献者展示仁慈。
So he expands himself in four different forms.
所以他把自己扩展为四个形象。
Right, Vasudev, Sankarshan, Prajumna, Aniruddha.
Vasudeva, Shankarshan, Pradyumna, Aniruddha.
So here in this world, even the demigods, they also worship the Lord in the deity form.
在这个世界，半神人们他们也用神像的形式崇拜至尊人格守神。
In the spiritual world, you don't need deities.
在灵性世界不需要神像。
But in this world, because the Lord is not present, so we have the deity worship.
在物质世界，主不是永远的显现，所以我们崇拜主是以神像的方式。
But we should understand there's no difference between the Lord and his deity.
但是我们应该理解到主和他的神像是没有区别的。
So we have to worship the deity very, very carefully and not make any offense.
我们应该很小心、很小心地崇拜神像，而不要做出冒犯。
Okay, let's see.So then Sukadeva Goswami tells us about, he's been telling us about Bharadvaj, now he's telling us about Ilavritavaj.
Sukadeva Goswami 前面讲述了 Bharadvaj 和这八个 Vaj, 然后再准备跟我们讲 Ilavritavaj.
And he said, in this place, the only one male is there, and that is Lord Shiva.
在这个地方只有一位男性，那个男性就是主西瓦。
And Lord Shiva is there with his wife Durga, and she doesn't want any man to come in that land.
主西瓦和他的妻子杜尔嘎在那儿。杜尔嘎女神不希望任何的男人进入那一块土地。
And if any man comes in, she will have him turned into a woman.
倘若有任何男人敢这么做，他就立即把她变成一位女人。
So Lord Shiva is always surrounded by 10 billion maidservants of Goddess Durga.
主西瓦恒常的被100亿为杜尔嘎女神的女仆所环绕侍奉。
So, Lord Shiva is, he's always in the with Lord Sankarshan, and Lord Sankarshan and Lord Shiva, they perform the work of destruction of the material world.
主西瓦总是崇拜桑卡山，他们是。
Lord Shiva knows that Sankarshan is the cause of the existence of Lord Shiva.
主西瓦知道桑卡山是西瓦自己产生的缘由。
So he always meditates on Lord Sankarshan.
所以他总是冥想着桑卡山。
Sometimes we hear that the snakes on the body of Lord Shiva are actually Lord Sankarshan.
我们看到西瓦身上有这个蛇，这个蛇其实是桑卡山。
So Lord Shiva is the incarnation of Tamagun.
主西瓦是愚昧属性的化身。
But they have nothing, both neither Lord Shiva nor Lord Sankarshan have anything to do with the material nature. They are transcendental.
但是主西瓦、主桑卡山，他们跟物质世界没有任何的关系，他们恒常的处于超然的境界之中。
But their activities are involved with the mode of ignorance.
但是他们的活动使他们卷入愚昧属性。
So then, now we hear about Lord Shiva, how Lord Shiva prays to the Supreme Lord.
现在我们将要听到主西瓦他是如何向至尊人格守神献上祷文的。
So Lord Shiva prays that he offers his obeisances to the Lord whose expansion is Lord Sankarshan.
主西瓦向至尊人格守神致以顶拜，他至尊人格守神做是桑卡山的扩，就桑卡山是至尊人格守神的扩展。
And he said, you never manifest, you cannot be seen or known by the non-devotees.One has to be a devotee to know you.
您不可能向非奉献者展示，你只被奉献者所知道。
He's praying to the Supreme Lord, right? He's saying that you are the reservoir of all opulence.
您是一切超然品质的储藏所。
You're the only worshipable person.
您是唯一值得崇拜的人。
And you appear in many different forms to satisfy your devotees.
您展示为各种形象，只是为了让您的奉献者满意。
And you deliver the devotees. Your devotees are delivered from material life.
您这个帮助奉献者获得解脱，您帮助他们脱离物质的束缚。
So Lord Shiva prays.Please accept me as your servant.
主西瓦继续祈祷道，请仁慈地接受我为您永恒的仆人。
Lord Shiva says he's praying also for Lord Sankarshan. He said, "We cannot control our anger."
主西瓦还说道，我们无法控制我们愤怒的力量。
So when we look at material things, sometimes you get very attracted, sometimes you get very put off by them, we don't like them. Sometimes we're attracted, sometimes we hate them.
有些时候我们看到一些物质事物，不可避免地被它吸引，或者厌恶它们。
But you're the Supreme Lord, you're never affected like that.
但是您是至尊人格守神，您不被这样的事情所影响。
So if we want to conquer over the senses, we have to take shelter of your lotus feet.
如果想征服感官的力量，必须托庇于主的莲花足。
Some, if people are not pure, then they cannot understand the activities of the Lord.
一个人如果不是那么的纯粹的话，他不能理解主的活动。
And when they look at the Lord, they think the Lord is intoxicated. They think he's drank too much because his eyes, they look at his eyes and they think, oh, he's drunk. He's been drinking too much intoxication.
有的时候这些不纯洁的人看到主的眼睛是这种红色的，他认为主可能喝饮了太多不好的这些饮料。
So they become angry at the Lord.
所以他们开始对主愤怒起来。
And so the Lord, he becomes angry at them.
主也会对他们开始愤怒。
So this is their illusion.
所以这就是他们的愚昧。
Just a minute. I lost my place.
大家稍等一会
儿。Okay. So, the wives of the serpents, the Lord Sankarshan is in the form of a snake, right? So the wives of the serpent demon, they become...agitated, just like when Lord Krishna danced on the hooves of Kaliya, the serpent Kaliya, the touch of the Lord's feet agitated all the wives of the serpent of Kaliya. All the wives of Kaliya, they were all agitated, seeing the Lord's lotus feet.
当蛇魔的妻子因主的莲花足的触碰而激动时，就像当时主 Krishna 在卡利的头上蛇头上跳舞的时候，卡利的妻子们看到主 Krishna 触碰她丈夫的这个头，她们自己也变得非常的激动。
But Lord Krishna, he doesn't get agitated.
但是主本人他并不激动，不受打扰。
Just like Lord Shiva, he doesn't get agitated.
就像主 Shiva, 他不被打扰。
When he was meditating, it's described that he was meditating and Parvati came and she began to touch his genital, but he just remained meditating. He didn't get disturbed at all.
就像主 Shiva 在冥想的时候， Parvati 过来有时候触碰他的生殖器，但是主 Shiva 并不被打扰。
So he's very dear, he's dira.He's very sober, his very mind is very controlled. Right, this Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Dhiras tatra namoyati, matras parshastu kontiya, sitoshna sukadukata, agamapayeno nityastam statikshasvabha. Matras parshastu kontiyat stoshna. Oh, dhinasmin yutade komaram yogan tatade hantara praktir dhiras tatra namoyati. Right? Dhinasmin yutade komaram yovanam jara tatade hantara praktir dhiras tatra namoyati. Just like you change the body, so person doesn't get disturbed. The changing body, give up one body.Give up the old body, take a new body. You don't get disturbed by it. So this is dhira. You don't get disturbed despite some agitating situation.
主 Krishna 在博迦梵歌中的 2.13 中说，正如几坤的灵魂在躯体里经历童年、青年、老年的变化一样，躯体死亡时灵魂便进入另一躯体，智者不会为此变化所困惑。
Just like,
而 Dhira 就是一个不被打扰、不困惑的人。
And Prabhupada gives the example of Prahlad Maharaj, that even though he was put through so many situations, he remained perfectly calm and peaceful.
就像 Prahlad Maharaj, 他在面对了很多困难的处境的时候，他仍然保持平静。
So Lord Shiva is praying, he's saying that all the great sages know that the Supreme Lord is the cause of creation, maintenance and destruction.
主 Shiva 继续地祈祷道，所有伟大的圣人和哲人都接受主是创造、维系、毁灭之源。
And the Lord, as Ananta Shesha, he holds all the universes on his hoods.
主被称为 Ananta Shesha, 他把所有的宇宙顶在自己的舌头上。
But each universe is just like a mustard seed on his head.
每一个宇宙的重量对于他来说却只不过是一粒芥末籽那么重。
So it's insignificant for Ananta Shesha.
对于 Ananta Shesha 来说，一粒芥末籽是非常微不足道。
So just imagine how powerful Ananta Shesha must be.
我们可以想象一下。Ananta Shesha 他是多么的有力量。
And then from the Supreme Lord, Lord Brahma is born.
从至尊人格守神那里，主 Brahma 诞生了。
And from Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva comes in the form of false ego, Rudra.
从 Brahma 那里 ，Shiva 诞生了。Shiva 被称为Rudra, 就是假自我。
And then, by Lord Shiva's power, he creates other demigods.
通过 Shiva 的力量，他创造了其他的半神人。
And he creates the five great elements in the senses.
他创造了五个元素和感官。
But he says, greater than all of us is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. We are all his servants.
但是他说，比我们更伟大的是至尊人格守神，他是，我们都是他的仆人。
I said even Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva himself, we're just like birds under the control held by a rope, and he's our master.
我和 Brahma 都在至尊主的控制下，就像被一根绳子拴着的小鸟一样。
So in this way.We hear about the supreme position of Lord Krishna.
如此，我们听了至尊人格守神 Krishna 的地位。
And the Lord's energy covers the minds of all people in this material world, keeps them conditioned.
主的能量覆盖着这个物质世界所有人的内在。
And if we want to get out of this illusion, out of the material world of illusion, we have to get the mercy of the Lord. Only by His mercy can we ever get free.
如果我们想摆脱脱离于这个物质宇宙的话，我们必须以迷惑能量的话，我们必须脱避于至尊主，得到他的仁慈才行。
So this is Lord Shiva's prayers to the Supreme Lord. We see Lord Shiva, although Lord Shiva is also like a god in this material world, but he prays to the Supreme Lord.
我们看到，即便是主 Shiva， 他也向至尊主做出祈祷。主 Shiva 在这个物质世界就像主一样，主本人一样，但是他还是向至尊主做出祈祷。
So just imagine how great is Lord Krishna.
我们就可以想象到主 Krishna 有多么的伟大。
That Lord Shiva himself is offering prayers to him.
主希瓦本人向他做出亲自向他做出祈祷。
Okay, we'll stop here. Ask if there's any questions.
Yes. From the Chandra Vinasi, Vinasi Devi Dasi, 顶拜孤乳甜美的莲花族，顶拜翻译以及奉献者们。经典说，物质世界没有快乐，物质世界的快乐是暂时没有痛苦。那么什么天？为什么天堂上还有快乐呢？物质世界包括天堂星球的快乐和灵性世界的快乐。物质世界快乐包括天堂星球的快乐和灵性世界的快乐有哪些不一样？顶拜孤的仁慈，顶拜。Obeisance to Guru's lotus feet. In the sutra said, the material world there are no happiness, and even here is happiness. Just means no, a few time no suffering. So why, in the heavenly plant there have some happiness?
In the heavenly planets, they have some happiness.
Yeah, why in the heavenly plant have happiness?
Well, that's the nature of the design of the universe. That the pious people who have done pious activities, they go to the higher planets and they're rewarded. They're given some kind of sense gratification.
这是这个物质世界设计的这个本性。当一些虔诚的人，他做了一些虔诚的活动，他被提升到天堂星球，他们获得一些感官的享乐。
So, yeah, it's a high standard of happiness, a very high level of happiness, which we cannot begin to imagine about from our own experience in this planet.
是的，有一些高级的这种享乐，我们可以想象到，通过我们的想象，我们可以了解，我们可以了解到，在我们天比我们高的一些星球上，确实有一些高级的享受。
She's asking, why is there happiness on the higher planets?
Because in the sutra said, in the material world, there is no happiness. So why is that there is some happiness in the heavenly planets?
Yeah. Well, there's some happiness for some time, but it doesn't last forever.
是的，确实有一些享乐，那只是一段时间，但是它不是永恒的。
They have to come back again to the material. They have to come down. When they finish their pious activities, they use up all their karma, they come back.
当他们享受完他们的虔诚活动的业报之后，他们还是会回来。
Just like you go shopping and you spend all your money, and then when all your money is spent, you come back. Come home.
就像你去购物，当你的钱花光的时候，你就要回去了。
And wait till you get some more money, then you go out shopping again.
你回家，然后等待有再有一些钱的时候，你又去购物。Then she asked, "What's the difference between the material happiness, heavenly planet happiness, and the spiritual happiness?"
Well, it said, you know.When you go to the people who go up to heaven, they're enjoying for longer periods of time greater happiness. But the different levels of sense gratification.
天堂星球的人确实有很长时间的很高级的这种享乐。关于这种享乐是有很多不同的层面的。
We heard today how they enjoy on the earthly level.
我们今天听到了天堂星球的这种快乐的层面。
How do they enjoy? They have sex.
我们听到了他们如何享乐，他们有性。
And then when they have one year before the end of the life, they get pregnant.
他们在他们的妻子的最后的一年才怀孕。
So on the higher planets, how does it differ? What happens on the higher planets?
Higher planet and the material, happiness and the spiritual happiness.
On the high, on the, in the heavenly planets, it's the same business. It's just going on for a longer time.
天堂星球其实和地球的是一样的事情，只不过他们的时间比较长。
But the same business, eating, sleeping, mating, defending.
但是是同样的，吃、睡、防卫和交配。
But we heard that these people are very pious. Even though they're engaged in sense gratification, they never forget the Supreme Lord.
我们还听到，这些人即便他们在感官享乐，他们仍然不会忘记至尊主。
They're just attached. They get attached to sense gratification.
他们只是非常依附，沉迷于感官享乐。
But
and the spiritual world.
Prabhupada gives in the spiritual world, there's no sex.
但是在灵性世界是没有性的。
But there's beautiful women. There's people have their wives. They have their companions, they enjoy the beauty of each other.
灵性世界也有美女，她们有伴侣，她们非常的美丽，她们互相享受着对方。
Yeah, the women are all very beautiful, the men are also very strong and handsome, and they're youthful, they don't get old, they don't get disease.
在灵性世界他们非常的美丽，女人很漂亮，男人很健壮，他们不会有年老，也不会得病。
But if you're in the higher planet, in the heavenly planets, you can't stay there forever. You use up your activity, use up your piety, you go back down.
在天堂星球。你不会永远的享乐，你在那里用完你的前程活动的时候，你就会下降。
So some people, some souls are going up and down, up and down, up and down.
他们只是上就像我们刚刚描述的，用完前程活动就会下来，他们只是上上下下的，你上去一下，然后下来，上去一下，然后再下来。
They use up their pious activity, they come back to earth, then they do more pious activity and go back to enjoy more.
他们做一些前程活动，然后上去，然后再回来，然后再做一些前程活动，然后再上去享受更多。
So, our Bhagavatam purports are telling us, don't be so foolish to live like that, going up and down, come, get out from this world.Finish this business.
但是我们刚刚师姐薄伽老禅所描述的，不要做这些愚蠢的行为，不要这种上上下下，我们要离开这个愚蠢的地方。
Some people are very, we know, some people are very much attached. They can't live without sex.
我们知道有一些人非常的愚蠢，他们没有性生活，无法生活。
So that's also there in the heavenly planets. But the difference is that the people in the heavenly planets are very pious. And even though they're engaging in these sinful, in these activities, they remember the Supreme Lord.
我们也听到在天堂星球的这些人们，即便他们在享受这种生享受，但是呢，他们非常的虔诚。他们在享受的时候仍然能记住至尊主。
So Prabhupada explains how, you know, lower creatures like dogs and pigs, you know, they're very attached to also sex.
圣帕帕的也描述这些猫啊狗啊他们也非常依附性生活。
And they get pregnant twice a year.
他们两年怀一次孕哦不一年怀两次孕。
And each time they will deliver six piglets or six puppies.
每一次他们就生六只小狗六只 小猪。
So this is the business of hogs and dogs.
这就是猪和狗的事情。
But it's not the real goal of life.
但它不是人生的真正目标。
Okay, any other questions?
Yes. She asked, in the那些天堂星球，他们在享受性快乐的时候，是不是只是暂时没有痛苦的情况下的快乐体验呢？ So when they have the sexual happiness in the heavenly plane, is that they just temporary no pain and while they have the happiness experience?
Yeah, right. That's right. It's the pleasures of the senses are like that. It's short, temporary.
是的，就是这样的。感官享乐的这种快乐其实就是这样的，只是短暂的。
Flickering pleasures.
是这种摇晃不定的快乐。
Of course, in the higher planets, in the heavenly planets, on the level of the demigods, there's not the anxiety which we have on the earthly planet.
当然，在天堂星球，他们在享受的时候没有这种焦虑。顶拜孤儿的莲花族，恒河可以清除一切罪恶并免除疾病。那些在全球疫情蔓延的情况下，是否住在恒河边的人们能更加安全和幸运呢？全球有很多的人在这次疫情中死亡，其中多数是病弱的老年人。这也是主在地球为了减轻地球的负担吗？我们这样才能更好地得到主的保护。So obeisance to Guru's lotus feet, the Ganges River can clear all the sins and material disease. So in this coronavirus, whether the people nearby the Ganges, they are more safe and fortunate.
Oh, definitely, yeah.
必然是的，是的。当然是的。
If you take advantage to go to Ganges every day and bathe there, it's very good for your health. I don't think anybody getting corona if they do that.
如果你每天都去恒河沐浴，你一定会从这个沐浴之中得到一些益处，会免于这种新冠。
We heard people bathe in the Ganga.They benefit physically and spiritually.
我们听到经典描述，他们不仅在身体上得到益处，然后在灵性上也会得到益处。
There was one king of Jaipur. He would only bathe in the water of the Ganges.
我们听到在斋普的国有一个国王，他。只在恒河沐浴，不在任何的别的地方沐浴。
So one time it was arranged, the king of Jaipur, he was going to England. He went by ship.
当他要去英国的时候，坐船去的时候。
So he arranged a special container, filled it with Ganges water, so that he could take bath every day in Ganges water.
然后他安排了一条大船。这个大船只是装着恒河水， 以便他到了英国去之后能够每天在恒河里沐浴。
And he kept very good health bathing in the Ganga water.
因为在恒河沐浴他有很好的这种健康。
So some people they have this habit, they will only bathe in Ganga water.
有一些人就是有这种习惯，他只在恒河沐浴。
Some people they only drink Ganges water.
有一些人他只喝恒河水。
There was one brahmachari, he was living at the temple and here in Mayapur, a Gaudiya Math temple, where they have the Gorgadhar deities at Champahati.
在这个 Mayapur 有一个 Gaudiya 的庙，他们崇拜的是 Gorgadhar deity， 在 Champaka 庙，在 Champaka 那个地方。
Champakahati.
在 Champakahati.
And the man lived there, he was a brahmachari, he lived there alone.
他是一个真守身，一个人住在那里。
And he was very old, he was not up to 90 years old.
他非常的年长，将近90岁了。
And he was
90岁以上。
He was worshipping the deities every day, Gorgadhara.
他每天崇拜神像 Gorgadhara.
And every day he would half fill his belly with Ganga water.
每一天他都在恒河沐浴。
No, her, he hella.
每一天他都喝恒河水。
Half fill his belly, he would fill half of his belly with Ganga water.
他每一天让恒河水喝满他半个胃这么多。
So he kept very good health that way.
他以此有很好的健康。So, then she asked, with the global epidemic spreading, will the people living of, no, many, many people are died with the disease, are old people. So is that the Lord will, the Lord minus the earth respond?
Take away the burden.
Yes, yes, yes.
of the planet.
So, yes, yes.
Reduce the burden on the earth. Yes, just like in the time of Lord Krishna, there were many demoniac kshatriyas. Krishna arranged the Kurukshetra war.
是的，就像在这个 Krishna 那个年代，有很多的这种恶魔的 kshatriya， 于是就当时发生了 Kurukshetra 战争。
So, Mother Earth, she went to Lord Brahma to complain. Her planet was overburdened with all the demonic Kshatriya kings.
So, this Earth Mother went to Lord Krishna to pray. She said, "Our Earth now contains too many evil beings."
So, Lord Krishna arranged the Kurukshetra war to reduce the burden on the Earth.
所以 ，Krishna 这个安排了库鲁之野的战争，然后让减轻地球的负担。
So the same way, now there's many old people, so Krishna's relieving them of their material bodies through this coronavirus.
现在确实有一些老人 ，Krishna 通过这个病情把他们带走。
Well, it's all Krishna's plan, Krishna's arrangement.
一切都是 Krishna 的安排。
You give up one body, take birth some other place.
放弃一个躯体，然后去到另投身在另外一个地方。
But for the devotee, they can take the opportunity to go back to Godhead.
对于奉献者来说，他离开躯体，他可以回归守身。
Okay, any other question?
Another question from Pio. I come. 敬拜 Gurudev 的敬拜敬爱的 Gurudev， 请问 Krishna 的子孙，他们也是灵性的吗？ Krishna 离开这个物质世界之后，他们的后他的后代去了哪里？ Obeisances to dear Gurudev, I want to ask the son and the grandson of the Krishna, they are also spiritual. When the Krishna depart from the this material world, where he is descendant.
So, yes, Krishna's son, Krishna's grandson, they are also spiritual. They also have spiritual bodies. They come to take part in Krishna's pastimes.
是的 ，Krishna 的孩 ，Krishna 的儿子 ，Krishna 的子孙，他们都是 Krishna 的，他们都是灵性的，他们都是来参加 Krishna 的逍遥时光。
And when Krishna leaves the world, then all of his associates, all of his family members, they also go back to their places.
当 Krishna 离开这个物质世界，回到他的星球的时候，他的子孙也回到他们自己的地方。
Just like we said, when the earth was overburdened, she went to Brahma, and Brahma prayed to Vishnu, and Vishnu told Brahma that I'm going to come, and you should all take birth in the Yadu dynasty.
当这个地球有负担的时候，这个地球母亲到 Brahma 那里祈祷， Brahma 到主威士努那里祈祷，主威士努告诉 Brahma， 你们也应该投身在 Yadu dynasty， 亚杜王朝之中。
I'm going to come in the Yadu dynasty. You also can be there. We'll be together.
主威士努对 Brahma 说，我会投身在这个亚杜的王朝之中，你也应该在那里。
So, before Lord Krishna departed from the world, Lord Krishna arranged for the Yadu dynasty to fight with each other, to annihilate each other.
当主 Krishna 在离开这个世界之前，他安排了亚杜的王朝的所有的这些人，他们相互之间残杀。
Well, Yadu dynasty were so powerful, nobody could destroy them.
但是亚杜王朝他们非常的强大，没有人可以伤害他。
So they destroyed each other.
所以他们就互相杀掉了对方。
And when they destroyed each other, then they went back to their positions as demigods.
当他们互相杀掉了对方的时候，他们就回到了各自的位置上。
And those who were pure devotees, those who were the from the spiritual world, they went back to the spiritual world.
Oh, 就是除原来是半神人的，他们回到半神的地方。那些是纯粹奉献者的这些子孙们，或者说家族们，他们回到灵性世界。
So they all had spiritual bodies.
他们所有的人都有灵性的躯体。
All the residents of Dwarka during the time of Lord Krishna, they all had spiritual bodies.
所有 Dwarka 在 Krishna 这个时代的这些人，他们都有灵性的躯体。
Mm-hmm. 还有问题吗？
还有。Next question from Sati Madhaji.Hare Krishna, 顶拜孤的莲花族，当协会内部因为一部分的服务项目出现纷争，而我们因为不了解具体的情况，或者没有仔细了解具体的情况，而被动参与到一些纷争的事情当中时，自己却认为只要是在服务奉献者就没有问题。请问孤乳，这种服务的心态对吗？我们是不是只要服务就好，不用理会协会的这些建议和纷争？ Hare Krishna, obeisance to Guru's lotus feet. When the when the east come, inside the east come, there's some servant program have some how do you say, 纷争.
Shenzhen?
Argue, yes, sorry.
Okay, okay.
Okay. Servant program have some argue, but we don't understand the details of this. And we can't, when we don't understand, but we do some things in this argued things. So I think is when, if it is also, if it's still the service, devotional service, then it's no problem. So I want to ask you, this kind of mood is all right? When this argument happens, I think if these things are still the servant, so I think it's no problem. I want to confirm this mood is or is right or not.
Yes, I think so. I think it sounds all right.
我认为是没有问题的。
People argue that, you know, the argument shouldn't be too big. It shouldn't get too out of hand.
这种，但是这种争论 need to serve and ignore the the East Council suggestions and these arguments.
So what?
So do we just need to serve and ignore these East Council suggestions or the arguments?
Yes, we just focus on our service. Don't get involved in arguments.
是的，我们只是专注于服务，不要涉入到这种纷争之中。
We don't want to get involved in all the arguing which is going on, the politics.Just leave that to other people. Let them, if they worry about it, let them worry about it. It's not our department. After Prabhupada's spiritual master left the planet, then all the devotees began to argue.
当圣帕帕德的灵性导师离开这个物质世界的，离开这个星球的时候，他的这些门徒就开始争吵了。
Yeah, they were all arguing about the property. I should get this. This is ours. This belongs to me.
他们就在说，这是我的财产，这些属于我。
But Prabhupada just focused on preaching. He concentrated on preaching.
但是圣帕帕德总是专注于传播，他总是专注于传播。
So we don't need to get involved in all the arguing. Just let other people, you know, worry. They want to do these things. We can just focus on preaching, chanting and preaching and distributing Krishna consciousness.
让别人喜欢或者说担心这个纷争的人，他们去考虑这些事情。我们专注于这个自己的唱诵以及去传播。
That's much nicer.
这会更好。
We get the influence of the age of Kali is that we begin to argue with each other.
卡利年代的影响就是我们开始和别人争吵。
So we have to try to keep the personality of Kali out. Don't let him come in our midst. Just concentrate on what we're supposed to be doing, which is Sankirtan. And spreading the holy name.
传播圣名。
Okay.
Hare Krishna.
Yeah.
是这样，是这样。如果我们不小心，
如果什么？
如果我们不小心没有了解具体情况，已经参与到这个纷争当中，是什么样一个情况
？Then give it up, stop。
如果我们不小心参与到，那我们就应该立马的放弃，停止。
It's not worth it.
那不值得。
但是还是认为，因为是一种服务嘛，我认为这个也是在服务奉献者呀。我觉得还就是服务奉献者就好了。
Well,
我并没有想参与身份证啊。
You have to know how to serve devotees. Arguing is not serving devotees.
你应该了解什么是服务奉献者，纷争不是服务奉献者。
You want to serve the devotees and show them the nice example, encourage them in sankirtan, encourage them in preaching.
如果你想服务奉献者，你应该展示一个好的榜样，好的榜样，好的唱诵，好的传播。
Don't show them the example of being a big politician, getting involved in all the arguing.
不要向他们展示你是一个伟大的，你是一个大的这种政客，你参与到这种纷争之中。
明白吗？萨提不高兴。
会有不高兴，会有人不高兴。好的 ，Good day， 感谢您。我们看下面的问题吧。
好。
Next question from Radha Priyam Mataji， 顶拜孤儿的莲花组，感谢主持翻译的服务。请问孤儿对于启迪后奉献者发生的所有一切，是否是 Krishna 为他回归灵性世界的安排呢？或是业报？该承受的呢 ？Abasing to Guru's lotus feet, I want to ask when the people initiate, and then while after initiate, everything he happened is just the Krishna's arrangement or his karma?
Yeah, it's Krishna's arrangement, but a devotee thinks it's karma.
是 Krishna 的安排。但是奉献者认为这是业报。
We have a little karma, a little bit of karma there. We just have to finish it off.
我们确实有一些小小的业报，但是我们需要把它完成。
It depends on how we are fully surrendered at the time of initiation.
同时还取决于我们是如何全然的臣服。
The initiation is not just the ritual, it's the actual submission, it's the total mood of surrendering to Krishna.
启迪不是一个仪式，它是一种承诺，一种完全的臣服于 Krishna 的承诺。
So if we've actually, you know, really genuinely submitted ourselves fully and faithfully followed all the principle, then it's Krishna's arrangement.
如果我们真的全然的遵循这些规范原则，那一切就是 Krishna 的安排。
But a devotee also thinks that whatever sufferings he's undergoing is due to his karma.
但是奉献者有时候还是会认为所有发生的一切只是他自己应该承受的业报。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Mathura Nina Manaji. 顶拜孤类和所有的奉献者，请问孤乳灵性躯体是什么样，和物质有什么区别 ？Abasing to Guruday and devotees, I want to ask Guruday.How is spiritual body like? What's the difference between the spiritual body and the material?
Well, Krishna had a spiritual body. Krishna just looked like an ordinary person, right? But he, of course, he was very beautiful, very handsome.
Krishna 有一个灵性的躯体，但他看起来像物质一样。他非常的美丽，非常的俊美。
We said all the inhabitants, all Krishna's family, they also have spiritual bodies. Nanda Maharaj, Mother Yashoda, Vasudev, Devaki, they all have spiritual bodies. Their bodies are just like human bodies, but they're spiritual.
We say Krishna's family, Nanda Maharaj, Yashoda, Vasudeva, and all their family, they are all spiritual. They are very beautiful. They look like a human's body.但实际上他们是灵性的。
So their bodies are Satchit Ananda, full of bliss and knowledge eternally.
他们的躯体被称为 Satchit Ananda, 永远充满着灵性，永恒灵性充满了喜乐和快和知识。
So just like there are different bodies here in this world, there are similar bodies in the spiritual world.
就像我们在这个物质世界有各种各样的躯体，在灵性世界也有多种多样的躯体。
There are horses, there are cows, there are frogs, there are snakes.
那里有奶牛，有青蛙，也有蛇。
But they have spiritual bodies.
但是他们是灵性的躯体。
Anyway, when you go there, you see.
不管怎么样，你如果去到那里，你就会看见。
Radha Priya is very eager to go.
Radha Priya 非常渴望去
and she's very qualified to go.
她也很有资格想去。This question from Mathura Leela.
Oh, Mathura Leela, she can also go.
她也可以去。
Okay.还有问题吗？
目前没有看到。
没有了，Guru Dev。让他们俩妈再继续说感谢 Guru 的祝福。
Hare Krishna。OK， 今天到这儿，感谢苏布迪布布啊。
抱歉，又有一个问题。
yeah.
Varadas Savara. This question from Varadas Savara. Devi Dasi. 顶拜 Gurudev， 请接受我卑微的顶拜。请问 Guru， 当看经典时记不住，是不够诚服吗？不够谦卑吗 ？When I read the scriptures, I can't remember. Is that means I'm not surrender or I'm not humble?
No, it just means you need to read it again, and you need to read it again, and you need to really concentrate and try to remember.
这只是意味着你需要再看一遍，然后你需要专注的去看，然后你就可以记住了。
Right? Usually it says you have to read three times.
通常我们说我们应该看经典三遍。
Brahma read the Veda, he studied the Vedas three times.
Brahma, 他看韦达听三遍。
So you want to learn something? You're not going to learn it one, just reading it one time.
如果我们确实想学什么东西，我们不应该只看一遍。
You have to read it very carefully. You have to really concentrate when you read it.
同时，当我们看的时候，我们应该仔细的、非常专注的、聚精会神的去看。
So you have to really focus your mind and concentrate. Then you gradually, it takes a lot of effort on our part to remember everything we read.
逐渐的你会当你付出了很多的努力的时候，你花掉了很多的努力的时候，你会记住这一切。
You know, we're not like people in the other ages, they could just hear one time and remember everything.
我们不是先前其他年代的这些人们，他们只听一遍就可以记住一切。
But because we have such bad memories, that's why Vyasadeva had the Vedas all written down.
因为我们有很差的这种记忆，所以维亚斯德把所有的这一些经典写了下来。
So we can have them read again and again.
这样我们就可以一次又一次的阅读。
So you please read again and again, keep reading.
所以请您一次又一次的保持阅读。
Just keep the desire that you really want to remember and understand. It's not just remember, but it's also understand.
请保持着你这份渴望、愿望，不仅仅是就是一直阅读，不仅仅只是阅读或者记住，应该去理解，还要。
So it helps when you try to explain it and discuss it with other devotees.
这会帮助。我们在和其他奉献者交流讨论的时候，会帮助到我们。
Okay, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
So Ganshya Subhuri Rai, Gevaman Fani, Ganshya Sati Jujur, Ganshya Sayodhu Fungshensa, Lingting, Tiwanti, Juniman, Wanshang, Hao.
谢谢
Guru Dev. Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Lord Bhaktivinoda ki.
Jai. Goodbye, Guru Dev.